Montana High Court blocks hearing in resentencing rapist of girl. CNN.com. Sub edition, U.S. International Mexico Arabic. TV, CNN, CME, CNN, en Espanol, HLN. Sign up login. Home DVN video, CNN, Trends U.S. World politics, justice, entertainment, tech, health, living, travel, opinion, I report, money, sports. Share this. Print. Email. More sharing. Reddit. Stumble upon. Delicious. Montana High Court blocks hearing to review rapist's 30-day jail sentence. From Kung Lan, CNN. Updated 11:17 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, Friday, September 6, 2013. Story highlights. New, Attorney General says having state high court decide is only way to get justice. State high court orders hearing vacated, says it will address sentence on appeal. District Judge G. Todd Daw had scheduled the hearing for Friday. He says a 30-day sentence he imposed in a teacher who raped a student may be illegal. CNN saying outrage over his sentencing of a rapist to 30 days in jail could have been avoided, if I'd been more alert or, if the state had pointed out his error. A Montana judge confirmed that a higher court barred him from revisiting the sentence on Friday. As part of that same decision, the state Supreme Court ruled that Judge G. Todd Daw couldn't hold a hearing he had scheduled to reconsider the sentence. Daw had planned to reconsider the punishment after outrage over his initial sentence of a teacher who admitted raping a 14-year-old student. He explained Friday that he now understands that the conviction carried a minimum of 2 years in jail, not 30 days, and called Friday's hearing to address his mistake. The high court order came shortly before this hearing on Friday, the judge said. After it did, Baugh said that he signed paperwork that, over his objections, sends the case on to the higher court. The appeal process will proceed forward, the Supreme Court will review the matter, and they will issue whatever orders they think are appropriate at that point in time, Daw explained as to what will happen now. In a strange twist to an already odd case, the defense and prosecution agreed that Friday's hearing should be called off, albeit for very different reasons. Both sides questioned whether revisiting the sentence was even legal, with the defense saying nothing should change and prosecutors saying changing it could hurt their appeal. They got what they wanted when the state high court vacated the hearing. Victims mom to judge, you were wrong. Judge wants to over on rape sentence. New hearing in Montana rape case. We conclude that the stated intent of the district court to alter the initially imposed oral sentence in today's scheduled hearing is unlawful and that the proceedings should be arrested, the court said. We take no position in the legality of the imposed sentence and will address the party's arguments in that regard in appeal. Noting his office appealed to the state Supreme Court on Wednesday, Montana Attorney General Tim Fox cheered Friday's decision and the fact prosecutors are moving forward with the process. The only way to ensure the rule of law prevails and justice is ultimately served is for my office to appeal the sentence, Fox said in a statement. The defense, meanwhile, believes the sentence earlier announced in court by Daw, with all but 30 days suspended, should stand. In a response filed Thursday with the Yellowstone County Court, defense attorney Jay Lansing joined prosecutors in saying that a new hearing would be without legal authority. The case drew widespread attention when Daw imposed the 30-day sentence in Stacey Dean Rambold and made controversial comments about the victim, saying she seemed older than her chronological age. Rambold admitted raping the girl while he was her teacher at her high school. Cherish more or less took her life shortly before her 17th birthday. In an order this week, the judge said it appears the mandatory minimum is 2 years, not 30 days. He said the court, if necessary and appropriate, would amend the sentence at Friday's hearing. Such a hearing, however, would create confusion and uncertainty for all parties left to interpret and execute the sentence of Mr. Rambold, Lansing argued. He said his client contends the sentence imposed, which prosecutors are appealing.